Saturday, November 4th, 2017. This is Henrik, and I wish to speak to you about love. That's really all life is about, really, is love. Love gave birth to life, and life manifests this love. So when love beckons to us, my dear friend, let us follow love. Though love's ways sometimes may be hard and steep, and elevating and wonderful, that is our recompense. And when love's wings enfolds us, let us yield to love. Though the sword hidden among his fields and realms may wound us. And when love speaks to us, my dear friend, let us believe in love. Though love's voice may shatter our dreams after elevating them, just as the north wind will lay waste the gardens. For even as love crowns us, so shall he, love, crucify us. Even as love is for our growth, so is love for our pruning. Even as love ascends to our height and caresses our tenderest branches that quiver in the sun, so shall love descend to our roots and shake them in their clinging to the earth. Like sheaves of corn, love gathers us unto himself. Love threshes us to make us naked. Love sifts us to free us from our husks. Love grinds us into whiteness. Love kneads us until we are pliant. And then love assigns us to a sacred fire, that we may become sacred bread for God's sacred feast. And then love assigns us to a sacred fire, indeed, that we may become sacred bread for God's sacred feast. All these things shall love do unto you and me, that we may know the secrets of our hearts, and in that knowledge become a fragment of life's loving heart. That if in our fear we would seek only love's peace, and love's pleasures, and love's delights, then it is better for us that we cover our nakedness and pass out of love's threshing floor. Into the seasonless world, where we shall laugh, but not all of our laughter, or weep, but not all of our tears. Love gives not but itself, and takes not but from itself. Love possesses not, nor would it be possessed, for love is sufficient to love. Isn't that so? When you love, you should not say, God is in my heart, I'm in love, but rather, I am in the heart of God, and life is loving me. And think not that you can direct the course of love. For love, if it finds you worthy, will direct your course. Love has no other desire but to fulfill itself. But if you love, and must needs have all of love's desires, then let these be your desires, my desires, our desires, to melt together to fuse into the light and be to the light of love and to be the like the a running brook that sings its melody deep into the night and awakens with the morning star. Let us know the pain also of too much tenderness that within eternity can only be but ephemeral, although each instant of this ephemerity is an eternal instant of love. Let's be ready to be wounded by our own understanding of love and to bleed willingly and joyfully and to wake at dawn with a winged heart and give thanks for one another and for another day of loving and to rest at the noon hour and meditate love's ecstasy to return home in the evening with loving gratitude and then to sleep with a loving prayer for the beloved in our hearts and a song of praise of love upon our loving lips. For love will set us free. Love will carry us forth. So as we carry our few drops of precious warm blood and divine heart across the glaciers of eternity, let us remember to love one another, to love all things created, to love oneself, and to love life and love itself.